Okay. The next talk is titled Efficient Side Channel Protection for ARX Ciphers by Bernhard Jung, Richard Petri, and Mark Stuttinger. And Richard is on the stage.
Yeah, thank you for your introduction. As said, we are talking about efficient side channel protections of ARX ciphers. ARX ciphers, as a short introduction, consist of addition, rotation, and exclusive OR as their basic building blocks. And the things about these ciphers, they're quite easily protected against timing side channel attacks, but they're quite hard to attack against power or EM leakage attacks. And the usual culprit is the modular addition, as seen in the previous in a text and previous released attacks. And early work on this by Gobon suggested that we use Boolean masking for the to protect the rotation and the XOR, and then do a conversion to arithmetic masking to secure the modular addition. And this is quite costly. It has a cost of k, k being the bit width of the addition. This was later lowered to log k with the suggestion that we apply Boolean masking directly to an addition algorithm. And we do this in software directly. And previous talks already mentioned threshold implementation, so I'm not going in too much detail with this. But it was mainly of interest in hardware implementations due to needing three shares for first order security, but recent developments have reduced this to two shares by introducing a registering stage. And we use threshold implementations to implement a masked addition algorithm. And we introduce some optimizations. The first of is we introduce mask versions of combined gates, or combined gadgets is also often the term, which perform a shift, an AND, and optionally also an XOR in one step. And we these combined gates allows us to use the flexible second operand of the ARM platform, which will perform an operation including a shift in one single instruction, and usually in a single cycle. And we introduce a method to reduce the number of necessary remasking steps and reduce the amount of required entropy for their implementation. Not in this presentation, we introduced a simpler algorithm for modular subtraction, which is needed by some ciphers like the spec cipher in the decryption slab. And as an additional algorithm, we used the Coggestone adder, here shown as a simplified circuit diagram. This adder is a parallel prefix adder, which means it processes each bit in parallel, not just like the like a ripple carry adder, which will process each bit sequentially. So this is quite optimal for software because each software instruction will process n bits in parallel. So we use this. And what I want to highlight is these blue gates, which is a combined shift and an XOR, which we'll use to speed up the operation. All right, I'm going to first introduce an AND XOR gate. As shown before, the goal is to split the operation into multiple shares, in this case, two shares. And this would be a quite straightforward approach to implement an AND gate, secure AND gate. The problem is one of the properties of the threshold implementations was violated, which is the uniformity. To gain uniformity, we need to introduce a guard share M. And this is where we stepped in to optimize a bit and developed a method to reuse one of the inputs as a guard share. Because, as said, all the bits are processed in parallel, so we can use one of the inputs shifted by the left, and we need to shift in essentially one random bit. So the software just needs, the AND gate just needs a single fresh bit. But in the case of an AND combined with an XOR, we don't need a refresh at all. We just simply replace the M with a shares of the XOR operand. Then we can do a shifted AND XOR gate, which is quite heavily used by the Coggestone adder. And this lends itself quite well to the armed flexible second operand, which can perform, for example, one of these calculations in a single instruction. And of course, we can also combine this with an XOR, so we don't need a refresh mask at all. So to protect Coggestone adder, this would be the algorithm we use to perform the modular addition. And we simply replace all the gates, like the AND gate, the XOR gate, and these special shift AND XOR gate, and or just the shift AND gate with the secured variants like this. And what I want to highlight here is this part. As said, we reuse a single bit of one of the input shares. In this case, for example, before the addition, the first bit of the X0, or each time the first bit of one of the proper gates, we reuse in the next iteration. And to highlight why this works, I'm going to show the simplified diagram again. As said, during the iterations, the first bit is never used. So we can reuse this as a guard share. So this allows us to implement a modular addition, which just requires a single random bit, the U, as an for remasking the entire addition. All right. Further optimization is possible. Previous works introduced a special AND gate, which doesn't require any remasking at all. And we can combine this with our approach of the combined AND shift or the AND shift XOR gate, which we'll call the secure AND optimized and secure AND shift optimized gates. And we compared this with previous works. Of course, we aren't a lot faster in the secure XOR gate or the secure shift gate, which we don't need at all. We're not really a lot faster with our secure AND gate. But notable here is the combined gates, the sec AND shift and the optimized versions, where we will only need 8 instructions in the ARM case, and we can lower this to even 6 instructions. And even more notable, the previous work here always requires a refresh mask for an AND gate, which we only need a single bit. And generating this single bit will only cost us 3 instructions. Okay. We also did an instruction count measurement for the complete modular mask addition, for a 32-bit modular addition on an ARM platform. And we were able to improve by almost 31% when we combine this with previous works, as seen here. And our subtraction algorithm, which I haven't mentioned yet, is a lot faster than this. So, yeah. Okay. And to reiterate, our complete addition algorithm only needs a single random bit, and it also outputs a single random bit. So we can implement, for example, the ChaCha cipher, where each addition in the ChaCha cipher, modular addition in the ChaCha cipher, will produce the next random bit for the next addition. And we measured the performance for the ChaCha cipher as well. And as we see, the overhead of the mask implementation is quite large with our reference implementations, implementation just needing below 2,000 cycles. The overhead is quite immense. We compared this to previous results, which were, we didn't find a lot of previous results, but this is this. And if we use the optimized gates, we can shave off a bit more. And we see that masking the addition is quite a driving factor in protecting the cha-cha cipher. And just to note that the cycle counts aren't quite comparable because we measured on multiple platforms and the results varied a bit, we think due to differences in the memory architecture. Right. We also simulated the our cha-cha cipher with using the microarchitectural power simulator called MAPS. We extended the simulator by 11 instructions, and the simulator samples the Hamming distance for each risk register assignment, and performing a t-test on a fixed versus random setup with 100,000 noise-free traces will not result in any leakage. But we think still noise amplification methods like shuffling should be used because it's just a simulator. Okay, that's it. Thank you for listening.
Thank you. Any questions? Okay. Can you get back to one of your source codes that you showed about where you used, for instance, one of this? Can you explain more about this secure and shift, or secure or secure and shift XOR? You are following a particular concept, which should be, I mean, you refer to threshold implementation about this.
Yeah.
Yeah. Can you explain more about what you do here, and what is the difference between this shift XOR and shift? And probably I imagine that the XOR is helping you because you don't need more fresh randomness.
Yeah. We went into this with this part. So this would be a basic implementation without XOR. Mm-hmm. And without our mask reusage scheme. So we do a cross product with the two shares, with the AND gate. And the threshold implementations, the work we are basing this on, which allows us to reduce this to two shares, requires that we can't recombine these shares without registering the S shares, without registering them first. Mm-hmm. But in software implementations, everything is registered, so we don't need to use that. And if we want to later recombine this, we need to put in a refresher mask, the M.
Okay.
And what else?
Now, my question here is, do you completely ignore the architectural issues of the microcontroller? Means that you have a pipeline, for instance, and you are not completely aware of the details of the pipeline. And then consecutive instructions in the pipeline may have effect on each other.
We know that the pipeline has an effect on this. We did measurements on a real platform. Mm-hmm. We need to add a few instructions to flush the pipeline in some cases.
But it's some kind of ad hoc, or you identified which parts you have to introduce new instructions? Or it's a systematic way to say that, okay, if you want to implement or if you want to run this secure AND XOR, then you have to put those extra instructions between two consecutive instructions.
This is just a baseline implementation for a protected implementation. Any microarchitecture will introduce some leakage which we don't know about, for example, pipeline leakages. And so you need to add some, for example, in the ARM case, we added some XOR instructions, which don't process any valuable data. which will flush the pipeline and will remove additional leakage.
You know what I'm concerned about? If you look at the first two instructions at the left, if they are in the pipeline and if you are going to the same bus, the XOR between them will be actually leaking, right? For instance, the XOR between S0 and S2. It may lead to direct leakage.
Yeah, it might.
Yeah? Okay. Good. But the simulations that you have done doesn't consider such an issue. Just as you simulated just the values which are processed.
Exactly. It just shows that the register distance during the assignment, the Hamming distance, that this won't leak. And the simulator also considers two pipeline registers. So we also show that these won't leak. Mm-hmm. But of course, for example, we might, especially the shift might leak during glitches. We're not sure.
Okay.
And the simulator is set. Well, back up slides. What I wanted to say. Okay.
Okay, thank you. Any more questions? Okay, let's thank the speaker again.